Welcome back to the Welcome back to part three of our Gears of War Lancer build. We're going to focus on painting and weathering and really bringing this weapon or prop to life for your next cosplay. If you're being intimidated at all at this point, don't be. Just take your time, do what you have to do, and make changes if you need to, because it's going to be your design. So it doesn't have to be exactly like this or exactly like the one that you see in the game. It's okay to make changes and to do the things that you have to do to make it your own build. So if you have any questions about how we've gotten this far, go ahead and leave a comment down in the comment section down below, and I'll try to get back to you. And of course, thank you for liking, subscribing, and commenting. And let's go ahead and get started with the painting part of this. And it's really going to bring it to life and make this much more realistic. See how realistic it gets? All right, let's go. In this video, we're going to take this basic weapon that is a single color, and we're going to bring it to life with some good painting. Now, this weapon is all EVA foam minus the barrel here, which is PVC. Everything else, besides small little details, such as this little piece here, which is plastic, these little details, which are googly eyes, things like that, it's 100% EVA foam. And it's all been sealed using Plasti-Dip. So I've got the Plasti-Dip on. I've got some LEDs actually inside of it, which you can't really tell from there, but here's all the mechanisms for it. So I've got some windows that are taped over here, here, and back here. So if you notice, I'm not really paying attention to those areas because that tape will come off eventually. But we're going to start this off with a solid undercoat, which is all regular black acrylic paint. So this whole thing has been done, both sides, with acrylic. I have my reference image handy, which has some of the detail work, and I'm basically going to follow that. I've got a dark gray for some of these areas, which I've mixed up myself with some white and black. I made a dark gray. I've got a metallic. I've got more black if I need it. And since the stock is actually supposed to be wood back in here, this is supposed to be wood, I've got two shades of brown. So we're going to use these to bring this blank solid color weapon to life. We're using all acrylic here. And I'm going to start off with the darker gray. Got my reference image handy so I can see which pieces really need it. And I see that this piece is going to be the darker gray. Now I've got an extra layer on this that stands up, so I can separate that layer or make the whole layer, this whole thing, gray. I think I'm going to do this top layer with a dark gray. And maybe do some silver underneath it. It's really up to you. I recommend using your reference image to get you started, but you don't have to follow it 100% exact. And we're basically just going to cover this whole thing in detail using our regular acrylics. And once we get it painted the way we want, I'm going to seal the whole thing with a clear coat, and then we're going to weather it. And the weathering process is what really brings this to life. And these are the sections that I chose to do. This piece, this little segment here, the grip, part of the magazine, this part here, top and bottom. I actually have to go over that. The top piece is here, and this middle part of the chain rail. And I'm just going to go through and add my second layer, and Once I'm done with that, we can move on to the next layer, which will be the silver metallic paint. The metallic I'm using is Dazzling Metallics brand from Deco Art. It's a metallic acrylic paint, and with two or more layers, this actually does a pretty good job of looking pretty shiny. First layer will look, you know, not quite realistic, but as you add more layers, it'll really get a good shine to it. So don't be disappointed if you put some on and that first layer looks a little generic. There's one layer of metallic right there. Doesn't look too bad for just having one layer. So I'm going to build upon this with some different layers of the metallic, and then I'm going to add different colors as we go through, and I'm going to seal the whole thing, and then we'll start weathering. The paint job is moving along. We've got this color, we've got some silver. I'll show you the areas that I'm doing it in case you want to follow along with a similar type of paint job. Just pick little areas like that in the top of this site, and of course the metal in the very top. When you're painting, don't worry too much about if you know you're going to paint something over top of this. If you go outside the lines, don't worry about it. Just go ahead and get that part done, let it dry, and then when you're going over, then be careful at that line. If not, you're going to spend too much time worrying too much about detail, and your paint job's going to take a whole lot longer. Also, don't be afraid that if you do go out of lines or you get some on there, you can go back over with some paint and just paint back over it and touch it up. So these layers of black, gray, and silver are done. I'm going to start with the stock, which is supposed to be a wood color. So I'm going to use these two shades of brown, which is a earth brown and a moccasin brown, basically a dark brown and a lighter brown. And I also think I'm going to carry that wood design up to the grip up here. I don't want it to be just black, and I've got enough gray and silver going on, so I think that transition, it'll look like there's wood here and here, and it'll kind of draw it all together. Now I wanted to take a minute just to show you the difference between having a flat color and bringing this color to life. It's a little difficult to see on this side because of the shininess of it, but if I can get the light out of there, you'll see there's actually some color variation in there. And we're going to do that on this side, so it's not so flat and cartoony looking. And we're going to do that using the same brown paint that we already have right here. I just moved a little bit over into here. I'm going to take a little bit of black just to darken it. Just a slight color variation. And this will just allow us to have a little bit of a contrasting color in the brown. So I'm just going to take a brush, going to just get most of the paint out. Nothing specific here. And I'm just going to get a little bit of this darker brown. Wipe most of it away so I can just go through and just add it in some areas. Once I have it added in these areas, I'm going to wipe some more of that paint off. I'm just going to use my brush to kind of blend it out a little bit. Specifically the edges of it. I'm going to repeat that for the stock as well. I'll zoom in a little closer here. And on this, I'm going to go up along the edge, pull it down a little bit. One of the corners where I think might be darker. Fade that out. Specifically the edges. My brush is pretty much dry at this point as I'm fading this out. put some more dark on there, dry your brush out, and blend it. I'm repeating that process in a couple places. Now these are going to be very subtle differences in color, very, very subtle. And you won't really notice them at all at a distance. But when you're up close on it and you're looking at the fine detail, it'll really make this stand out. Make it look more like a wood grain. And the last thing we're going to do is we're going to speed dry this. And we're going to add a lighter highlight. So let me go ahead and dry this. Now if you look, if I can find the camera angle here, here we go. If you look, you can see the dark spots in there. It's just enough to break those colors up so it's not just so ordinary and flat. Now to really bring this to life, I've got a fan brush. You don't have to use a fan brush, it's just what I have. You can use any kind. I'm going to use a lighter color of the brown. Just need a very, very small amount. I'm going to put a little bit in my tray. I'm going to do a very similar thing to the last time. I'm going to put a little bit on my brush. Wipe most of it away. That way I am only getting the very lightest amount of paint. And I'm just going to pick a direction and add little tiny bits of paint highlights. Now again, this is very subtle. You hardly see any of the paint going on, but that's pretty much the point. We don't want a lot of lighter streaks showing up, you know, throughout the paint with obvious brush strokes. And again, this just is another technique to break up a solid color. Now again, it's very subtle. It's hard to see the highlights. But there's some highlight here. Some more up in here. Right here. And those little bit of highlights are just enough to really keep this color broke up and looking more like a real wood grain versus just a flat brown color. I mixed up my base gray and added a little black to it just to make some different tones. It's very subtle, the difference in color between this and the black, but it's different enough from this gray to add a different gradient of color to this weapon just to break up that flatness. So I'm just picking some spots that I want to add this slightly darker, well, it's actually lighter than the black, but it's much darker than the gray. So it's an in-between color that really will work together. It'll be very subtle, but it'll be noticeable up close. So I'm just picking some places that I want to add these to break up that flat black color. And I suggest you do things like that as well. Find the colors that work well together and use different variations of that color. Add a little black, a little bit of white, and mix it up. So I'm gonna do this strip here, and then I'll be done with this. I'm gonna add another layer of the brown to thicken that up and to make it more solid, and we'll go from there. And now the paint is done on this side. The next step is to take it outside and hit it with my clear coat. I really only have this gloss, which I don't like. I'm hoping that gloss will dull down when I start doing my finishing. If not, I'm just going to have a shinier weapon, which will make it look a lot more new, which is not really the look I'm going for. But I was out of matte paint, and I stopped at two places, and I could not find any matte clear coat. So I'm going to go ahead and take a chance and continue with the gloss. And once this has had time to dry with the gloss on it, we will look at how to weather it and make it look a little more realistic. Okay, this weapon has been clear coated. Again, I'm not a big fan of the shininess, but I'm going to deal with it for now. And the next step would be to distress it or weather it. And all you really need is some dark paint and some water. And all we're going to do is thin down some black paint to make it pretty good and runny, because we just want this paint to be thin enough to get down in the cracks. Even though most of this is black, it won't show up, but it'll show up in other areas where we want it to be black, and then when we'll wipe most of it away, it'll leave some of it behind. Got some paper towels handy. Got a bigger chip brush. Now I can pretty much leave all the darker black alone because it's not going to show up anyway. But in areas like down in these cracks, it'll really help highlight those cracks and add a feel of dirt to it. Down all these cracks. You want it to be thin so it'll go down in these cracks, so when you wipe it away, a lot of it will be left behind in those cracks, which will give it a sense of being dirty and used and old. And you'll also get it down in the cracks and the little dimples of the foam and such like in here. Really makes it look like it's worn and old versus just being a prop gun. I'm just going to go ahead and try to dab it over the whole thing just because it might bring down the shine a little bit. I'm wanting this gun to look a little bit old, so I'm not trying to wipe it all away. I want a little bit of it to stay behind on some of the lighter areas, specifically the silver or the metallic, to make it look like it's old and worn and dirty. I'm just going to keep repeating this process until I'm happy with it, and I can add more layers, make it dirtier if I wish, wipe away as much as I want to make it a little more pristine. It's really up to you and your preference. And this is the process you'll repeat for the whole gun, making sure that dark gets down in the cracks so you can leave some behind to give it a better sense of realism. As long as you don't leave this on for a long amount of time, the paint's not going to stick. That's what we put the clear coat on for, to protect the paint underneath. So don't stress about ruining your paint job. If you put a good, solid clear coat on it, you should have nothing to worry about. And if you're not feeling like you're getting enough of the paint to wipe off, you can always use a wet towel. It will pull more off. But I'm liking the weathering look of this. Just the stock itself now. It's dirty. I don't like that spot. It's dirty around the rivets now. Got some gunk up in here and along the back of it. And that's going to give it a sense of being old and used and not so pristine, which is not the look we're going for. Here we are with the first side weathered. There's a little bit of gunk in the cracks and crevices, particularly up in here around the buttons. I put some on here and just lightly dabbed it off to leave some behind, because that's a pretty flat and smooth surface. It didn't want to really find any cracks and crevices to fall down into. Went over this a second time to add a little more around this guy, got some more in the corners, and I decided since this front end is mechanical and it runs these blades, I went ahead and sprinkled or flicked paint off of my paintbrush onto here to resemble grease splatters. So basically, all I did was take my brush and flick it like this. And that shot it out enough that some of the droplets got on there. And anywhere there was too many, I just patted them off. And don't neglect areas with this. Make sure you get all the cracks and crevices you can. Again, on the black, it's not really that important, but you don't want to neglect an area and have that look pristine in comparison to the rest. So now I'm going to speed dry this. I'll try to wipe this out because I have a light in there. I'm going to speed dry this with my hot air gun, and then I can move over to the other side. One more quick thing I wanted to point out is, just as I expected, using this wash on here, having the abrasion of the brush and then the paper over top has really taken that shine down quite a bit. Here's the side that hasn't been weathered. Here's the side that has. It's much duller. So I was hoping that acrylic would help break that shine, and it has quite a bit, so I'm happy with that. So if you have to use a clear coat to protect your finish, you can get rid of that shine using some aggressive brushing and toweling, I guess. Both sides are now complete. The shine has been reduced and it's nice and grungy and distressed looking. And I have two more things I want to do. I want to add some blood up here on the rail. I tried mixing up some acrylics. I got this color, which is a little too dark. So I'm going to go another route. I'm going to try some food coloring. And my base is going to be a little bit of Mod Podge. So I'm going to mix some food coloring with my Mod Podge. Mix that up. A little drop of blue, because there's a little bit of more color to blood than just red. Now that looks much more like blood than just red acrylic paint. So we've got our blood ready. But before we do that, we're going to distress this slightly more. And to do that, I'm going to go back to our metallic paint. You can do this with spray paint. You can do this with all kinds of different things. You can even use rub and buff. But I'm just going to use some acrylic. And I'm going to take a brush, an old chip brush. I'm going to put a little tiny bit in the bristles. Just a little bit. I'm going to work most of it out. Wipe it away. And then I'm just going to lightly do the edges, just to get some subtle scratching. This piece has been distressed. I'm going to do the same thing up here on the edge so you can kind of see it. And this gives another sense of battle damage and wear and tear. You just want to do this really light, just to add a little bit to highlight areas like this. Now I'm going to continue that process all around the weapon, except around the wood. The wood would not have metal scratching. So we're going to leave the wood alone, but everything else is fair game. So when you're doing the dry brush, make sure you wipe most of it away. And again, slight, light touch.
Some sort of corners that you think get more damage, less on others. Doing this, do as much as you think is necessary. What really will sell your piece. So don't be afraid to really try to.
Okay, I feel like I've added enough texture with the silver highlights, paying attention to corners and edges where I want to show some damage or some wear and tear, specifically up in here I made that really all worn down because that's where most of the action's happening with this weapon anyway. So now we're going to move on to the blood, which I've never done this before, so this is an experiment. So you're privy to my mistake or my success with this. But my thinking is Mod Podge dries clear, so that should leave behind this food coloring. Okay, I'm gonna get a larger paintbrush, but just because I want to be able to do the flicking technique on it. And I'm gonna focus most of it up here. So this seems awful thick, and I probably should have gloves on for this. So let me grab a pair of gloves. The acrylic comes off pretty easy, but this food coloring probably will not. Let's get some blood on here. We'll start. It's so thick it don't even flick. Let's see if we can find a thicker brush. Better yet, how about an old toothbrush? Let's see if that works. There's enough for flicking. Nothing. So I'm gonna go the old-fashioned way. I want to dab it on. So back to this. Usually I would just use spray paint and flick that on there, but it's 20 degrees outside right now here. I don't feel like messing with it out in the cold. I can tell you that's much thinner than I'd like it to be, so I may just wait, let all this dry real well, and use the spray paint, where I'll just get some red spray paint out and flick it on with the brush. That way I get a good spatter effect. But since I have this on the other side, I'll go ahead and use it kind of like a base coat of red. And then we'll be ready to seal this with a matte clear coat, and this will be done. All right, that's it. That's your complete build. You should have something that looks similar to this. Let's just start that over. I can't talk today. All right, that wraps up our three-part series for the Gears of War Lancer build. You should have something that looks similar to this or whatever modifications that you've made to make it a little bit different. That's really up to you. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to let me know down below, and I'll answer them as soon as I can. Thank you for following along with this fun build. I had a good time building it, and I hope you did too. Feel free to hit me up on social media if you build one of these, and send me a picture of it. I'd love to see it and share it with everybody else. So until next time, stay crafty, and thanks for stopping by. That didn't make any sense, did it? Nope, I'm leaving anyway. Bye!